Jet Systems as a direct marketing here. So we're going to get started. Before we begin, just a couple of items. One is this will be recorded. So if you want to review it at a later date or share it with a colleague, it will be on the Partner Portal website. Also, we will put aside some time at the end of the presentation to answer any questions you might have. So if you could just submit those using the Q&A panel, which is part of the WebEx interface, and we will sort those and answer them at the end of the session. Other than that, I'd like to introduce Murray Smith. He's our Technical Services Manager, and he's going to be taking it over from here.
Okay. Thanks, Tim. So in this this episode of XMetal in 37 Minutes, we're going to talk about extending XMetal Author using the Resource Manager. So just a couple of announcements first before we get started. The first is the XMetal Author Enterprise with Document and Webtop was just released, and XMetal Reviewer 6.1 was just released a few days ago as well. The next 37-minute webinar will be on June 17th, and it will be titled Getting to Yes, Overcoming Barriers to XML Adoption in the Enterprise, and Sue Lane will do that, that webinar. And just one other note, that there won't be a 37-minute webinar on the first Thursday of July, and that's because it's a holiday in Canada, so we're all going to take that day off. Okay, so this is the agenda for today's talk. There's a lot of stuff to go over, and this presentation is going to be pretty programmer kind of focused. So hopefully we don't have absolutely everybody dropping off the call now. I don't know why I said that, because there still might be some interest for people that are not customization implementers. Hopefully we'll get an idea of what's possible in XML Author and you know, how you can extend it. Also, since there's a lot of stuff here, I might not get through all the material in this this session, but all the slides and all the sample code will be available to everybody afterwards. And if it looks like it would be useful, then maybe there'll be a follow-on session to kind of finish this off and add some other things. Okay, so just some overview. So here's a little picture of XML Author, and the Resource Manager is on the left-hand side. The main editing panel here is on the right-hand side. And from the Resource Manager, you know, we can talk out to external systems and communicate and do things like that. So one of the key things to bear in mind that I'm going to talk about as we're going through here is that script code running in the resource in an HTML page in the Resource Manager is running in Internet Explorer's script engine, while script code running in XMetal is running in XMetal's script engine, and the two are separate. So we have to work out ways to communicate back and forth between them, and that's one of the things we'll be looking at. All right, so let's move on to the first demo that we've got here. Move over into XML Author. So I've got a little bit of demo code that will show some things. So this first demo is going to load a web page pointing to google.com, and it's going to just load it in the Resource Manager. And then after this, we're going to take a look at the code. So, you know, you can do whatever you want in here, search for things and other pages. Not a super interesting demo. You know, through scripting, you can have things like program the back button and things like that in there as well. Okay, so let's move back to the presentation and have a look at some of the code to get that page loaded in the Resource Manager. Alright, so here it is. There's only a few lines of code. It doesn't take much to load a page in the Resource Manager. So the first thing we do is we want to load Internet Explorer in there, and we want to give the tab a name, so we're going to call it Demo1. And if you look at the code down here, you'll see that so when we're adding the tab, we give it the name, and the second argument is the name of the ActiveX control. So for Internet Explorer, it's called shell.explorer. The next line of code just makes the tab the main active one, and resource manager, and then the one after that gets a reference to the Internet Explorer ActiveX controller, and we want that so that we can invoke some of the methods that are available on that ActiveX controller, like the next call, which is a method that tells Internet Explorer to navigate to a certain page. Okay, so pretty straightforward to do all that. Just one note. So when I talked earlier about, you know, script running in different script engines, this script here is running in the XMetal script engine. Move on to the next thing. So the next thing we're going to talk about is we've got a page loaded in the resource manager. We've got a custom page in there, and we want to talk out to some external systems. So let's move on to that demo. So this demo is going to load a web page that has a button on here that will call a server to get the current time in New York City, and then we'll insert it in the page. So we just hit our button, and there it is. It's the 3rd of June, and it's 1507 in New York City. So let's go and have a look at the code for that. Okay, so as far as loading the page itself in XML Author, loading it in the resource manager, all the code is pretty much exactly the same as it was for that first example. The only difference here is that when we tell it to navigate, we're giving it a path to a file on the file system. So I've got this file sitting on the file system. I don't have it sitting on a server. You could have it set up either way, but I just wanted to show the difference. So then we look at the code that is that's on the client side, so that's running in Internet Explorer in the resource manager. So basically, from here, an HTML page that's in Internet Explorer embedded inside the resource manager can do anything you can do in any HTML page inside Internet Explorer. So you can communicate in any way you want out of it. So in this example, I was using AJAX to make an HTTP call to a server, and it responds by giving me a little XML file that I can just go through and grab the time out of, and then I just insert it in the HTML file. So AJAX makes for a nice way to communicate out from the resource manager out to your backend servers. So this time we're going to talk about how we communicate from our page in the resource manager over to XML Author. And so again, we're coming back to this issue that there's two different script engines, and so we need to work out a way to communicate between these two different script engines. And we'll move on to a demo of this. Then we'll macro that'll load another page in the resource manager. So this page gets loaded, and what it does is it makes a call to that same web server to get the current time, and it makes a call over into XMetal and inserts that time in the access document at your current cursor location. So let me first open up a document in XML Author. Over here, and it made the call to the server, grabbed the time, inserted it into the document. So let's have a look at the code to do that. Again, it's pretty straightforward, actually. Okay, so loading the page is all pretty much exactly the same as it was in the first two demos, so I don't think I'll go into that. But here's what it looks like in the HTML page. This is the JavaScript and the HTML page that's sitting in the resource manager. And so that first line here is the key one. You need to be able to get a reference to an object, to the SNL application object. And once you've got that, then you've got access to the entire API for XML Office. So any other kind of calls you can do to the API, you can now do from your page in the resource manager. So for example, what we do here is first we get that object, then we get the active get a reference to the active document that's being displayed in XML Author. It's a quick check to make sure there actually is a document to open in XML Author. There is an active document. And then if there is, insert the time at the current cursor location. So outside of this little snippet of code here, time gets initialized to the value returned by that web service. All right. So now we're looking at from the other way around. So we want to communicate from script running in XML Author over into our page running in the resource manager. Same issue as before, two different separate script engines, so we have to work out a way to communicate back and forth. All right, got another demo. Loaded. Okay. So this loaded a pretty simple little page in the resource manager. There's nothing much in it. And then I've got another macro in XML Author that I can run that will ask me for a string to type in. So when I hit the OK button, it's going to make a call over and pass this string over to the page running in Internet Explorer and the Resource Manager and insert it into the document. So there we go, so it's done. So let's have a look at the code that's necessary to make that communication to pass that string over. All right, again, loading the page is pretty straightforward, same as the first two examples. In our HTML page, you can see that there's a little bit of JavaScript in there. It's got a function called WriteMessage that takes a message string as an argument and then grabs a little placeholder for an element inside the HTML document and writes that string into that placeholder. Now we look at it from the XML Author side. So how do we communicate over to the page in the Resource Manager to invoke that JavaScript method? So the first thing we need to do is get a reference to our ActiveX controller, our Internet Explorer ActiveX controller that's running in the Resource Manager. So that's our first line of code. The second line of code is once we've got that reference, then there's an API for that ActiveX control, and one of the API properties is a document object. So once you get your document object, you can do pretty much anything that you can do in HTML to the document once you've got a document object. Okay, so one of the properties of a document object is the script property. And script object, and the script object has a method on it called exec script. So that'll execute a script that's loaded in that document page. And so that's all we do is just execute that write method script. It takes an argument of a string. So the string is really any JavaScript. It doesn't have to be a function call. You could load any kind of script you want in there. The second argument over there is just telling us that this call is this JScript. And so we've got the write message, and then I'm just inserting the string value of a message variable, and that message variable was the string that we entered in the prompt dialog. So, again, pretty straightforward to make a call over and have a script over in the resource manager. All right, so let's move on to some slightly more advanced topics, but not really too much more advanced. So the first thing is that when you've got script code running in SMLS, you're going to make a call over to a HTML page in the resource manager. You need to know for sure that that page is fully loaded, because if it's not loaded and if it's not fully loaded and you go to try to do something like get that reference to the document object, it's going to throw an exception. Okay, so we need some way to make sure that when we load that page gets fully loaded, and then we can move on and do other things. Okay, so we've got one more demo here. So this demo is going to load a page. It's going to take a little bit of time to actually get loaded, so it's going to point to fully loaded. Callback gets executed over my script code and XML author that says the page is fully loaded, and then I'm going to just pop up a little dialog to say that we're done. We'll run the script, and this is the script running in XML author. So the page is still loading, it's still doing its query, and then callback got executed over on the XML author side, and then after that I popped up a little alert to say that the page is loaded. So let's have a look at that code and see what that looks like. Okay, so the basic overview of the process is sort of shown in this diagram. What we're basically going to be doing is we tell the resource manager to load this page in Internet Explorer, and then the page is going to initialize. While that's happening over here on our script running in XML author, we're going to wait for that page initialization to complete. Once the page initialization is complete in Internet Explorer, it's going to make a call back over to the script and tell it that it's fully initialized, and then we're going to continue on and do things. So the way we do that is we've got another ActiveX control, and what we're going to do is we're going to load that ActiveX control in Resource Manager, and it's going to load Internet Explorer in it, which is going to in turn load our page. And the reason we do that is because this extra ActiveX control, the critiques util one, it's got some code in there that can listen for a callback on the IE control that tells us when a page is fully loaded. Okay, so let's have a look at this code. So this is our code to load our page. It's a bit more complicated than it was in the initial one, where all we were doing was loading the page. So let's have a look at some of the stuff. The first thing in this little yellow box here is this is our callback code. So we're going to pass an object instantiated with this code into our navigate method, and when the navigate method completes and that page is fully initialized, it's going to execute this function called onwc navigate complete. In this example here, all I'm doing is setting a flag saying true, the navigation is complete. So then let's look at the next sort of different thing about this code. When we go to add the tab of this other ActiveX control, which is coded itself to then load shell.explorer inside it. And then over on the left-hand side, the next thing to look at in the box is that instead of using the navigate method, we're going to use the navigate to method. And again, the navigate to method is a method of the Internet Explorer ActiveX control, and it's also a method of this critique util control, and it dictates a second parameter, which is an object that's going to call back to when the page is fully loaded. And that's what we're doing over here on the right-hand side in that other little yellow box. We're instantiating an instance of that object is going to receive the callback. And then if you look at the code further down, all we do is once we've told it to navigate, we've got a little bit of code that just sits in a loop, going to sleep for a tenth of a second at a time, and then checking to see if that flag has been set to true, the one that's going to get set in our callback method. Okay, so you can see that we can get that page loaded. We can know that the page is fully loaded. So now let's move on to our next and last sort of advanced topic here. Kind of funny because I thought it was going to take me a long time to get through this, but I'm going through it a lot faster than I thought. Or just talking a lot faster than I thought. Okay, so the last topic, advanced topic, is parameter passing between XML author and your HTML page. So again, the issue is that we've got code running in two separate script engines, so we need to work out ways to pass parameters when you're, you know, invoking a macro over on the XML side or invoking some JavaScript over on the IE side. So one more demo. And this last demo. This last demo loads an HTML page that allows the user to enter a string, and then the string is passed to XML, and a macro to display the string is invoked. So let's have a look at that. We loaded our page. Again, just the same old thing for loading a page. This guy here, we can type in some string here. And then when we click on this button, it's going to invoke the JavaScript method on that page that is going to pass this string over to XML author, and then it's going to invoke a macro that's going to go and grab that string and display it to us. So there we are. We passed it over and it's been displayed. So I'm just going to have a look at the code for that. So the way we pass parameters back and forth, XML author has this custom properties capability. And basically you can add any object that you can instantiate in script, you can add that as a property. And you can do that from outside of XML author. You can put an object into the custom properties. And then from script inside XML author, you can grab that object from the property, and vice versa, you can go the other way around. So here's a look at our code. So we just, from our code, this is code running in Internet Explorer. So first we need to get a reference to the XML application. So that's our first line of code there. The second line of code adds this method string. It gives it a name, calls it message from HTML page, so that code on the other side can refer to it by that name. And then it tells the XML application to run this macro called display message from HTML page. And I don't think I actually show the macro code, but it's in the collection of sample code that you're going to be able to receive from this presentation afterwards. You can have a look at it. All it does is it just does the inverse. It goes to the custom properties and gets that item using the name message from HTML page. And so let's do that pretty fast. Hopefully it didn't confuse people too much. So basically you can load HTML pages running Internet Explorer in the Resource Manager. It's a really flexible way of being able to do a lot of different things. Resource Manager is a great place to put stuff like that. It's a nice place in the screen, right beside the editor. You can put all kinds of information and controls and access in there to let you do a lot of different things. One of the things we've been talking to one of our partners, they make a three-dimensional control for looking at like machine drawing kind of stuff. So you can imagine a case where where you have someone who needs to write the manual for how to assemble some kind of mechanical assembly. Wouldn't it be nice if you could pop up that drawing in the resource manager, and they can manipulate that drawing, sort of pull pieces off, they can figure out how the order for assembling and disassembling this control, and then wait there in XML where they can write down their instructions. So one of the things that we talked a lot about in this presentation was the script code running these two different script engines, and look at different ways to deal with that and communicate back and forth between the two of them. So lastly, a couple of resources for where you can get information. So here's a link for where you can get information on the Internet Explorer ActiveX control. This will give you information on the API, the properties, the methods that are available to it. And the second link there is an access to our XML API. So this is our programmer API, and this is for writing your macro code on the XML side. All right, that's it.
Perfect, thanks, Brian.
Okay.
Everyone got a lot out of that. If you don't have a lot of questions, we have two questions that are somewhat related. The first is, can you use Excel spreadsheets to manage workflows and to manage our content? Is there a way to script Excel into the resource manager?
That's actually a pretty interesting question. I don't know off the top of my head, but basically so inside the resource manager, you can load any ActiveX control. So if there is an Excel ActiveX control, which I'm guessing there probably is, then you need to get from the name of the control to be instantiated, and then you should be able to add it. And if we can get the name of that person, I can give it a try. I can see if I can find out what that control is called and how to get a hold of it.
Sure.
And see if it's possible.
Definitely. So we'll get back to that person. And then the second question, somewhat related, is other applications that I can call in the resource manager side.
Oh yeah. So that's exactly what I was just mentioning. So you can load any ActiveX control. So as long as there's a control for it, you can load it. So I was putting Internet Explorer in, but when I was talking about controls for viewing, three-dimensional drawings and that kind of thing, you could just put that control directly in. You don't need to put it inside Internet Explorer.
Hello.
Okay.
Okay, everyone. So thanks very much for attending. As Marie said, we will be not having a 37-minute external webinar on July 1st. It's statutory holiday here in Canada. So hopefully we'll see you on the 17th for our next XML in 37 minutes. As I mentioned, this is recorded and it will be available on the partner portal. So if you want to share it with colleagues or download it yourself or reference any of the code or URLs that are in the presentation, that's where it'll be. Other than that, we hope you enjoyed it and we'll see you in a couple weeks' time. Thanks very much.